Hello folks, welcome to the canal channel Jose. Today we're gonna show you or how to make a tire stop, so when you park your car in an uphill or downhill and you're trying to work on it, or at least park it so it doesn't roll down. So this is gonna be a homemade tire stop, so you don't have to spend a lot of money or just go buy one when you can make it with simple stuff that you have around the house. And with that, let's get started. And what most of us do is we put a rock or a piece of wood on front of or in the back of the tire. And what happens is that the tire, as it spins, it starts spitting it out because these are not anchored to the ground. So they start just being spit out from the tire. So they never make actually contact. Sometimes it's unsafe to do this. So we're going to show you how to solve this cheap way and easy way with some stuff in the home. So let's do this. And there are products out in the market for these kind of jobs, but they're from $8 to $20. But why paying that much when you can almost make it for free? So for this, we're gonna be using a 4x4 piece of wood, and this is about 12 1/4 long. So we just need it enough to where the tire is, the width of it, and so the tire can be wide enough to touch this piece of wood. And we're gonna be using 3 pieces of wood of 4x3 1/4, but actually these are 3 1/2 width because of what they call them, 4x3/4. And the length of them, we're gonna be using them 21 3/4, but what we're doing is that we're gonna be screwing these 3 pieces of wood onto this piece of wood. So we need just enough to where this is the body completely over the pieces of wood. And once we do that, what this is going to be doing is this be screwing to all 3, and that's going to be a platform where the tire is going to roll over. And once it touches this, because this guy is attached to these guys, this is not going to slide because the weight of the car is going to be in these woods, and it's going to keep the car from rolling more. So we put this piece of wood, screw down into these pieces of wood, tire rolls over it. Once it's, the weight of the car is on this, that's not gonna move, or even spaces, just about that. And once we have him set up like that, we're gonna screw him into the 4x4, and that's gonna give us a platform screw into that. So with that said, let's screw it in. And when you're screwing this wood down, the only thing I would recommend is to pre-drill a hole with a smaller drill bit than the screw. So that prevents the wood from splitting. If you don't do that and you just put the screw right in there, it's gonna split the wood. So you wanna pre-drill a hole. It's not gonna split the piece of wood. So what we have here, folks, is that we have now a platform, and I left these pieces of wood with some space, so in case the tire would have dirt or rocks or small pieces, it will fall in through here. And I know it's not a big, yeah, I hope it makes a difference, but what it's gonna do is a tire, we set it up into a tire right behind it, and then we roll the car into it, stops right in there. So let's put it to the test. Now what we do is we set it right behind the tire, and we line it up where the tire is right almost in the middle. And what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna let this tire or the truck drive over it and touch here, and we'll see what happens to this platform when we do that. We rolled our truck right over it, and now our tire is, we can see that there's all the weight of the truck is leaning in that, and these woods are keeping that wood from sliding away because the weight of the truck is right on top of that. So this guy is attached to all 3 woods we are in the bottom, so that keeps, like I said, that wood from sliding away. So this is a good, cheap, and efficient way to keep your truck or your car from sliding away in case you want to work on it or just want to park it for safety. And like I said, also you can make it higher so that way the tire cannot roll over it. But for me, this is the height that it works for me. You can even make it rounded. I made it square so it's harder for the tire to roll over it. But you can make it higher or you can make it rounded so the tire sits right like a half moon. But this is an idea how to do it. So I wanted to, now we're gonna roll the truck forward and see how it reacts. Well, folks, I hope you have enjoyed this video and you find this info useful towards your new next project. And like I said, this is only an idea how I made it for myself. It works out, so you can even make it a little bit more fancy. Take your time, make it higher, or if the tire are bigger on your car, you can make longer the base so they you got more space. And this is how I made it. Hopefully it works out for you and you find it useful. If you can find 4x4s, you can always use wood and 2x4s and put them on top of each other to make the height. And this is an idea, and we'll see you soon with more videos here on the canal de Chano Jose.